First shot of the day.
I love you, bro. You're my best friend.
She just pulled my back.
Nothing.
Why'd you do it like that?
And the mosh comes down here and goes straight to Hitch's dad.
What? Look at his back.
Stop. I didn't know.
His what?
Is doing regular bows thing.
All right, but I haven't vlogged in a minute. You know, Nick, when's the last time?
What?
No, I'm not gonna ask. Nick's actually up today at a decent time.
Well,
that's shocking.
That
no, I was gonna say, when's the last time you uploaded a video? All right, but today, myself and Mike are gonna be heading to Jeep right now. You know, just to get a few quotes. Nothing too serious. I was calling Seth.
Somebody else no. Still up the tank.
No, what are you talking about?
Where are you gonna park it?
The Jeep in my spot.
No, because if you park it, then I get the dibs in the spot.
No.
Yeah, because the next car that gets a dib on a spot is my car. So if you buy another car, it just cycles in. So
fuck out of here. It goes by years lived.
What?
No, you haven't been waiting. I'm before I kick your foot.
Fucking forehead.
Oh, whoops. I banged into your thing.
Hey, dude, take care of that.
Mike is so damn obsessed with the garage door, he's literally gonna sit out there until we back out just to close it. He thinks like it's gonna mess up his motorcycle or something. It fucking drives me crazy.
Salty because I made him walk with his broken toe.
look, ready? Watch when he gets to the door. Alright, I'm vlogging too now. Double vlog. Ivan, I'm here with Mike.
See, man, these youngsters, double vlog.
What are you talking about?
You gotta follow the rules, man.
Who set the rules?
I don't know. The old man. Caveman. I don't know. Rode it right into the rock, man. That's why I came from the rock.
So the rule is you can't vlog while someone else is vlogging. That's the rule. They stayed in.
Oh, god damn. But I will figure it out.
Right there. That's the one. That's the one I want.
I fucked up. As you can see, I was about to have a great day in the life. It was going well. And I didn't charge my camera. So yeah, I went to the Jeep dealership. As soon as I got there, I was literally about to record myself getting out of the car. Camera is dead. The camera stopped working. So that was a fail. And I figured, you know what? I'm not going to not upload a video today. So I figured I'd tell you guys what happened today. So again, I do formally apologize for messing up the day in the life, not charging my camera. It's been sitting on my desk because I've been pumping out the live comms, doing all that stuff, recording with Nate. So I do apologize. I fucked up. I'm not going to lie. Let me tell you guys something. A reason, and I've always been like superstitious about things. But then at the back of my mind, I'm like, there's no way this is true. Like, there's no way you doing a good deed for someone will benefit you in a way. Like, maybe it'll seem like that because something good will come to you, but I don't know. And I think my opinion may be changed on that. I may be talking out of my ass, like I said, but remember I was having the crazy dreams and all that. I don't know, but it just clicked in my head. Did you guys know I got sick like week and a half, 2 weeks ago, right? And the day before I woke up sick, there was a guy at the gas station. And he was paying for, I forget what he was paying. It might have been gas, because I heard him say, sorry, something tight money right now. And I was behind him in line, and he said that. And he only walked out with like a few dollars worth of gas. And before I can get the words out, I was going to like offer to, you know, pay for his gas. But I don't know what kind of mood I was in, whatever. I just didn't offer it. And he like walked away. I felt bad. I literally felt like shit afterwards. I was like, fuck, man. Like, it kind of sucks that people have to go through that. Like, I literally felt bad. I generally felt bad. I'm like, I just thought to myself, I'm like, fuck. But I was like, come on, man. You could have helped that guy. Like, you know what I mean? It was just in the back of my head. Something, it would have been a nice deed, but it was just, like, dumb for me to stress over it. You know what I mean? So I felt bad. I'm like, boom, I get sick. And then yesterday, I was at the gas station. And I'm checking out again. I got my Gatorade. I forgot what else I got. Maybe a Pop-Tart or something. I had a Gatorade, a Pop-Tart. And there's a guy there. And she's like, oh, you're $4 short. It was $4.39 to be exact. And the guy's like, really? Like, he's all just... I'm like, I'll cover the rest. You can just put it on my card. It's fine. And he like turns around slow motion and he goes, really, bro? And he like slaps his hand on the desk. Thanks, man. I appreciate it. And just walks out. And I think he could have been nicer about it. You know, like shook my hand, whatever. What's your name? I don't care about that. I'm just saying, whatever. I'm just trying to give you guys full details of what's happened. So I paid for it. And usually, I'm not going to lie. Usually in my head, I'm thinking, oh, some good's about to come my way. I did a nice deed. But it's always, if you do it looking for, I obviously don't, but I'm just saying this, the crazy shit I think about. if you do it and you're thinking in the back of your head, like, I got to do this. Maybe something good will come my way. I feel like it, if you do believe in it, it won't work. But if you kindly, if you're in that moment and you just do it out of the good kindness of your heart and you do it just because you felt like it and that's when you're not thinking of, that's when good things happen. And that's what I'm going to tell you why. I'm not sure of the laws in Illinois, but I do get the 125 over speeding ticket. And I think if I get another one, my license gets suspended or something like that, whatever. And I got out of a ticket like a month before I got sick. I got out of a ticket. Like, luckily, I don't know what I did the week before that, but I somehow got out of a ticket. I was going 16 over. And then today, after I got done looking at the Jeeps, or before I was looking at the Jeeps, I get a car wash, right? And the zones over here are so weird. I've never seen anything like it. It'll go from literally... The 35 end point will be here, and the 45 start point will be right behind, literally 5 feet away from each other. And the first time I got pulled over, the 55 zone was literally 5 feet away. I could touch it. That was the first time I got the ticket. And it pissed me off because I would have only been, I would have been only 15 over, and that would have just been a ticket or whatever, or I could have did the traffic safety school, nothing serious. I pretty much got the same punishment for as if it was a minor speeding ticket. Because I can go to traffic safety school and it's going to be gone. It's going to be off my record. So I'm not going to have any tickets. So anyway, let me get to the point. I don't know why I keep getting backtracked. So I pull out of the car wash and now it's the 45 zone. And there's a 35, right? So I'm going 47. Or no, what was I going? He said, how fast was I going over? He said 18 or something like that. I forget the exact. Anyway, I was in the 35 zone going 18 over. Whatever, right? But the thing is, and I know I don't want to make excuses, but... You know how you turn onto the flow of traffic? It's like you gotta speed up so you don't, one, so you can get with the flow. And I don't want anyone to hit me from the back. I'm not gonna go 2 miles as I'm pulling out of the wash. So I speed up so I can get in front of traffic. Like, so I'll make sure, like, they come and I don't get hit or anything. I'm not trying to get hit from the back. So I go speeding up, right? About to enter the 45 zone. I'm chilling. And I'm literally, it happened so fast, guys. It was in a matter of like 500 feet. The lights are on. And I don't know. And I'm like, fuck, man. So I'm driving, it, like at least 30 seconds to 45 seconds go by and I'm just cruising. And then I look at my back mirror, I'm like, oh shit, there's a cop behind me. What the fuck? So I just pulled over. And as soon as I got pulled over, I'm like, fuck, Bose. Fuck, why do you constantly do this? Like, you know it's gonna happen. Why do you keep doing it? Why? Funny thing is, another coincidence, so what was I doing the other day? Something with my car, changing my registration. I just had my insurance and registration out just for if I get pulled over. I had it ready. And just so happened I needed it, right? So he comes to the car, he's like, how you doing, good sir? He was like an older cop. He had to be like, I'd say 45 maybe. How you doing, good sir? And anyone in the comments, I don't know why, I'm not a cop, but every time I get pulled over, they, like, brush on the side of the car. They, like, run their hands on it or, like, their arm. I don't know why. If you guys can help me out, I don't know. I just noticed. I give them my whatever, but I always ask before. I'm like, my stuff is in that glove box. Can I go in there? Just double check him. So I go in there. I give him everything he needs. He's like, how long have you been a resident of Illinois for? And I'm like, fuck, dude. The last time I got pulled over, the cop told me, make sure you get this change. It's an invalid license. And I'm like, yeah, I mean, I travel back and forth. I'm a professional gamer. He's like, you're a what? I didn't hear you. I said, professional gamer. He's like, all right, cool. I'll be right back. Let's see what I can do for you. I'm like, the whole time, I'm like, fuck, Bo, you're gonna get your license taken away, you dumb idiot. You're so dumb. So he comes back. He's like, I'm gonna give you a warning this time. I went off topic. He's like, how long have you been a resident for Illinois for? And I'm like, well, I travel back and forth. I mean, I live here, but I was like, I travel back and forth. Usually I'm from New Jersey. I bought my car here, but I travel back and forth, you know, professional gamer. When it's almost travel month, I come here, which I mean, I was going to go to South Carolina like in a week. So I was like, I came to my head. I'm like, all right, maybe I can use this. So you don't live here. And I'm like, I'm like, I mean, my license says I'm from New Jersey. I mean, I travel back and forth. So that's when he comes to the car, he comes back. He goes, I'm going to give you a warning, man. Slow it down. The tickets are expensive over here. And I'm thinking in my back of my mind, I'm like, all right, let me just be nice to this guy, whatever. I'm like, all right, thanks, officer. I apologize. Yeah, what are the steps to get my license changed? You know, just trying to keep the conversation going. And he's telling me. And he was like, I don't know why I pictured it. He was just like, I can just picture my grandfather telling me. He's like, you need to go to the Secretary of State. Once you do that, you hand over your license. Once you do that, you may be required to take a test. I'm not sure how the state of Illinois does it. Because it is a new state, most likely we'll have to take a test. Should be easy. Got a new license. I'm like, all right, thanks, officer. I apologize. I shook my hand and everything. I'm like, oh my God, I just gotta have another like 18-20 over. Thank the heavens. And Krim gets so mad at me, bro, because he always gets tickets and I don't now for some reason. I don't know why. But I'm just thinking, like, I did a good deed for someone. Maybe it was good karma. I don't know. I don't know. Like, I kind of believe in it, but then at the same time, I don't know. It's weird, but I truly, firmly believe, like, a good thing happened to me. I don't know. Hey, man, I just want to share a story with you guys today. I know Sunday we're going to hang out at someone's house for the Super Bowl. Mike and Nick have a big tournament tomorrow for their regionals to get into the, Call of Duty Champions, the Halo Championships for $2.5 million. Spam the comments with good luck. Let's go, Optic Halo. I'll see you guys later. If you guys enjoyed, drop a like. Peace out, homies.